While addressing the press at Parliament, opposition legislators, led by the Shadow Minister of Education, Brendan Nabokenya, came out to oppose a move by UNEB to stay registration of candidates for schools that have not paid fees for Uganda National Students Association, UNSA.
UNEB also has its own mandate. If you let UNEB do the work of UNSA, that means if someone has not paid fees in UNSA, then they won't be sitting for the exams. This is not okay. We are seeing a big cost being put on our parents. Now all these associations have turned into political bodies.
Each student pays 2,000 shillings annually, which is collected by their schools and remitted to UNSA, but several schools have been defaulting. Last year, Uganda National Students Association indicated that students were defaulting to a tune of 3 billion shillings. However, legislators are not comfortable with Uganda National Students Association using UNEB as a trap to collect its arrears from defaulting schools. They believe it's illegal and will disable several students from registering for UNEB.
We condemn this and we want to hear the ministry speak on this matter, because there was a directive that they should write a circular to UNEB and UNEB should stop collecting fees for other organizations or bodies. We want to understand if this was done so that our learners in this coming examination year do not face the same challenge.
MPs claim UNSA has recently deviated from its core mandate to become another political organization which is used in the interest of the party in power, thus defeating the purpose of students' remittances.
Because schools are supposed to transfer this money directly to the UNSA accounts. But now if you subject UNEB to this, then there's a problem.
When there is a period of examinations, MPs get problem by having very hot calls on failure of some students to do exams, and they want now the MP to help to pay for different students in different areas of our constituencies.
Meanwhile, opposition legislators have urged government to consider doing away with UNEB registration fees to increase UNEB enrollments. Currently, 34,000 shillings is charged for PLE, 164,000 shillings for UCE, and 186,000 shillings for USCE. MPs claim it's not affordable.
This money can even be done away with, because if education is free and you are the one setting the exams, I mean the government is the one setting the exams through UNEB, if it is free, everybody is supposed to access it.
Relatedly, the Uganda National Students Association has vowed to run to courts of law following the closure of their office on the directives of the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Education and Sports, Katie Lamaro.
Ministry etugulireho office yafe, tusigalenga tutambuze minimu jafe, ne ministry letu yambeko, okusa empisa mumukozi wafe, eyandi banga aina sente ze yabula ankanya, oborusi nebi tabanga, nebi banga biyakole bitali bitufu. Because Yensongarwachi to in partnership with the ministry.
In a press conference held in Chambogo, the Uganda National Students Association, NEC leaders, have expressed their concerns following the closure of the association office. The offices have been closed with a pending case in courts of law against the NEC Executive Secretary Cherukwut Toskin, who they suspended from the office recently, accusing him of smuggling some articles into the association constitution in his favor.
So we tubanga tetwafuna report ezo ezili audited. We tubanga tulabe minimo tejitambula bulungi sente ziva mu organizations tezogerwa mu bwatu bwazo, atenga omuntu yomu alike misango ja koti twamusaba soke adeka amabali.
They have called for the president's intervention, who is also the association's patron, all to file a case in the courts of law. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi and Joseph Innocent Senfuma for the news.